Good morning and welcome to this service of morning prayer as we begin this day and this week praising God, the giver of our days and our weeks, who is with us always. And now let us join responsively in the opening greeting. Satisfy us in the morning with your steadfast love, O God, that we may rejoice and be glad all our days. Praise to the blessed and holy Trinity, one God, who gives us life, salvation, and resurrection. And now let us pray. We give thanks to you, Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have protected us through the night from all harm and danger. We ask that you would also protect us today from sin and all evil, so that our life and actions may please you. Into your hands we commend ourselves, our bodies, our souls, and all that is ours. Let your holy angels be with us, so that the wicked foe may have no power over us. Amen. The reading for this morning is from the scripture reading in James, the second chapter. My brothers and sisters, do you, with your acts of favoritism, really believe in our glorious Lord Jesus Christ? For if a person with gold rings and in fine clothes comes into your assembly, and if a poor person in dirty clothes also comes in, and if you take notice of the one wearing the fine clothes and say, "Have a seat here, please," while to the one who is poor you say, "Stand there," or "Sit at my feet," have you not made distinctions among yourselves and become judges with evil thoughts? Listen, my beloved brothers and sisters, has not God chosen the poor in the world to be rich in faith and to be heirs of the kingdom that he has promised to those who love him? But you have dishonored the poor. Is it not the rich who oppress you? Is it not they who drag you into court? Is it not they who blaspheme the excellent name that was invoked over you? You do well if you really fulfill the royal law according to the scripture. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. But if you show partiality, you commit sin and are convicted by the law as transgressors. For whoever keeps the whole law but fails in one point has become accountable for all of it. For the one who said, "You shall not commit adultery," also said, "You shall not murder." Now if you do not commit adultery, but if you murder, you have become a transgressor of the law. So speak and so act as those who are to be judged by the law of liberty. For judgment will be without mercy to anyone who has shown no mercy. Mercy triumphs over judgment. What good is it, my brothers and sisters, if you say you have faith but do not have works? Can faith save you? If a brother or sister is naked and lacks daily food, and one of you says to them, "Go in peace, keep warm, and eat your fill," and yet you do not supply their bodily needs, what is the good of that? So faith, by itself, if it has no works, is dead. I'd like to dwell this morning on verses 2 through 4. For if a poor person in dirty clothes comes into your assembly and you say, "Stand there," or "Sit at my feet," have you not become judges with evil thoughts? My wife and I lived in Fort Dodge for almost 40 years, and while there, I helped start a men's homeless shelter. But this is not a story where I'm going to be patting myself on the back for a good deed. Quite the opposite. We were members of St. Olaf Lutheran Church in Fort Dodge, which was just a few blocks from the homeless shelter. And each Sunday, a number of these homeless men would come to St. Olaf and sit in the back pews, by themselves, where I failed to greet or welcome them. And after church, during fellowship hall, they would sit together at one of the large round tables by themselves, where I did not visit with them. Instead, I sat with my friends wearing gold rings and fine clothes. So I took one step to help them, but I didn't take the last step that might have meant even more to them. And I've asked the good Lord for forgiveness many times over. The moral of this story? We can sometimes learn from our sin. Praise be to God. You have been made anew through this abiding and living word of God. Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Merciful God of might, renew this weary world. Heal the hurts of all your children and bring about your peace for all in Christ Jesus, the living Lord. Especially we pray for those who govern nations of the world. For the people in countries ravaged by strife or warfare. And especially for those living in Haiti, which has been ravaged by storm and earthquake. For all who work for peace and international harmony. For all who strive to save the earth from carelessness and destruction. For the Church of Jesus Christ in every land, including those in the Cathedral Parish of Same, Tanzania. O God, you have called your servants to ventures of which we cannot see the ending, by paths as yet untrodden, through perils unknown. Give us faith to go out with good courage, not knowing where we go, but only that your hand is leading us and your love supporting us. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. And now, Almighty God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, bless and preserve us. Amen.